Just the guy. Those guys.
Thank you. So Piper's going to come up and we're going to go ahead and we're going to start the people's press conference right now. Is Youssef here? Great. Wonderful. All right. So I'm going to introduce Piper. Thanks, Piper.
What's up, Detroit? Where's Detroit? Is Detroit in the building? We're outside the building. We're right in front of a bunch of nastiness that's going on right now. We want clean air. Who wants clean air? Who wants to live healthier? Who wants to enjoy the air that we breathe? We want clean water. We're right here by the water. This is a beautiful sight right here. It should be. But instead, we're faced with all of this disgusting, cancerous, gross piles of what? Petcoke. All right, so we don't want that, do we?
No.
What do we want? We want to live healthier. We want our kids and our communities to be able to breathe easier. We want our families to be able to enjoy the water, right? I know I want to enjoy the water. That's what's beautiful about Detroit. We're right here at the border. All right, so one thing that we got to do is we got to recognize our power. It's power in the people, right? The people united. What?
Never be the bar.
That's right. So listen, we got a truck right here that wants to get through, but we can't let that happen. Right?
No.
So we got to make a statement. This is the statement that we're making. So I want to welcome everybody for coming down to show support. So that's all the people right here. So just facing you guys, you know what I mean, need lots of support right now. So we want everyone that's watching, if you're streaming or if you're watching live, or even if you see it recorded, you know, the people need support. Detroit needs support right now. And this is a movement, okay? It's a beautiful movement, a peaceful movement. We're here. It's lots of peace and love right here. We're showing support. Look at the sunflowers, right? We're supporting clean air, climate justice. So this is a full love heart energy that's going into this movement right here. So what do we want to say? We want to let the Koch brothers and Marathon and Maddie Maroon know that we're posting a people's eviction notice. You're evicted. We're evicting you from this spot right here, right? This is an eviction notice, okay? So we're here, we're the landlords, we're the people, and we're standing strong so that you know we don't want this crap here in our communities, all right? We want to enjoy this water. We want to enjoy our air. We want to enjoy our community, right?
Yeah.
All right, where you at, party people? You know, it's a party right now. We're celebrating. We're celebrating this beautiful earth, right?
Yeah.
All right, that's what's up. So I'm going to bring someone up that's gonna, you know, let you know what our demands are. So we have our, today you're gonna hear from the city of Detroit. You're gonna hear our list of demands, and we're gonna answer some questions, and you're gonna hear from the also the Michigan Coalition of TarSands, okay? All right, so what you see right here, this is a lot of love. All right, do you guys feel the love?
Yeah.
This is what love is. It's a lot of love going on. So feel the love. It's a lot of love right here. All right? So we're standing in love right now, right?
Yeah.
It's all love. So I think I'm going to bring up, should I bring up my brother Youssef right now?
Yeah.
All right, so I'm going to bring up my brother Youssef. So let's keep this love going, guys. A lot of love.
Yeah. All power to the people. All power to the people. This statement here is about recognizing the human life of this great city. And recognizing this great city is about restoring the neighbor back to the hood. It's about the quality of the human beings. The state of Detroit is a state of oppression, of a state of exploitation. So this is a symbolic of the population and individual who continue to exploit the people here. When you look at the mayor, the acts that he's done over the last 5 years has been egregious to the city of Detroit, to the citizens. When you look at downtown, midtown, and coat town, you forget around town, the suffering of the neighborhood. And this is symbolic to what's going on in my lifetime, 40 years growing up here in the city of Detroit. So it's important that this is only the beginning. This is how a movement begins. In an oppressive time, The response to that is revolutionary action, revolutionary work, a revolutionary our minds, a building something towards, a building a movement of instilling hope. There's no hope, there's no peace. When you look at the food that we eat, you look at the water that we drink, those things in particular are shitty, are crappy. You know, just over the weekend, Saturday, you had Messy Jesse come in the city of Detroit. You had Al Sharpton come in the city of Detroit. You had Reverend Wendell Anthony, lead people down the street. Where are they at today? Do you see them in your community? No, they don't give a damn. The people have to give a damn. The people have to care. You know, and calling folks out, we're putting a demand on the humanity of the human beings. We're saying life in the city is valuable, and we're willing to fight for it. And if we're not willing to fight for it, how can you call yourself a human being? Whether you're white, black, purple, or green. But we cannot forget that this city is 85% black. So we look at the institutional structural racism, white supremacy, that is stripping human beings of their lives. But white supremacy is not a black problem. It's not a brown problem. It is a human problem. It is the greatest threat to humanity. The ability to exploit human lives, the ability to put more value on money, on property, than on human beings, is a disservice to humanity. So as a human being, you have a right, you have an obligation to make sure every human being is provided with a quality of life, with a quality of education, with quality of housing, with quality of jobs. That is our right as a human being. This is grassroots leadership at its finest, at its best. Popular leadership doesn't care about the people. They care about the corporate interests. This action here is the demand and show that we don't care about the corporate interest. We care about the people. This is a people's agenda. And we're challenging folks to understand that, man. You don't live in this community, but you're exploiting this community. And it will not be tolerated. All power to the people.